Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments. Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
So again, Amateur Radio Field Day is coming up June 22nd and 23rd at the Police and Fire Training Center in Fall River. I hope to see every one of you in attendance and members of the public. All of you are also invited as well to explore what Amateur Radio can do for you. Thank you.
This is not Alamance is to require the board commissioners to answer any appropriate questions. Speakers please address all comments to the commissioners as a whole and not to individual commissioners. Discussions in between speakers and members of the audience are not allowed. Speakers should be courteous in their language and presentation. Failure to abide by this requirement may result in forfeiture of the speaker's right to speak. Speakers who have prepared remarks or supporting documents are encouraged to leave a copy of such remarks and documents to the county clerk. This is a matter of public hearing on the budget. Therefore, it's not appropriate to discuss matters which are concerned against the feeling of person seeking public office. Matters which are this is a public hearing, you can talk about that. Matters which are closed session matters, including the anonymous matters of concern, it's not privileged, anticipated with any litigation, personnel, or acquisitions, matters which are confidential at all.
And then there was increased visibility. And so Even in the first 8 months of 2018-2019, library visitors numbered 16,244. Triple the amount of visitors we had in the entire 2017-2018 year, and the number of programs and computer users had already greatly exceeded the amount of the previous year. And these numbers are from the end of February, so I don't have all the way up to this date. And still, the library is only operating with one staff person. Currently, this library branch is only open from 12 to 8 p.m. from Monday to Thursday. It has to close for lunch for its staff members to take a break. A new part-time staff member would allow the library to increase the hours of the Norfolk branch to include Fridays and possibly one or two Saturdays a month, expanding the reach of valuable information to additional members of our community. I hope you will reconsider the library's original budget request for a new part-time staff member for Norfolk Park, and thank you for your time.
Madam Chairman, fellow commissioners, county staff, thank you for allowing us to speak tonight. I know some of you that know me, the trouble back in town, he's begging again. Well, that's true. But I'm representing farmland preservation, which is the future and sustainability of you and I in the future. I'm asking, we requested last year $250,000 to finance the program for the county matched by the state. This year, I'm asking for the same amount. Last year, we were cut $150,000. I'm not here just begging. I want to share with you commissioners some of the things that supports this program. Many of you remember in 2009 we had some major problems as it related to in the tax department. We initiated a program in 2009 to look at some things that need to be corrected, namely present use value program. Folks, to date, we have generated $2,085,143 in revenue to the bottom line for this county. Our estimated cost to recover that amount was $777,000, which give us a net profit or net return to the bottom line of $1,312,000. That's rough rounding it off. We found out when we started auditing present use value, there was a lot of deficiencies out there. To date, we have audited 1,728 farms, and out of that amount, that's where all this revenue has come. I'm happy to say those people are not still in agriculture, but we didn't know that. I'm happy to also to report to you that the tax department in this county is a different tax department today than it was 9 years ago. I'll give you a little tip. We had equalization and review board the other day, but we didn't have anything to talk about. That's progress, folks. I remember in 2009, we had somewhere in the neighborhood 1,000 complaints of people that was upset. We've done several things. We're now auditing, evaluating, reevaluation of the people that live in Alamance County. They know who we are, they know the values in our county, and they set the values. We just saved $1 million in rebound last time. I want you to consider, Mr. Haygood, keep us in mind on the day the last pin goes to paper. We need $250,000 because one of these days, and it's in the near future, we're going to wake up and there's no land to put the seed. That's our sustainability, folks, in the future. Let's step up to the plate. Let's do what we're supposed to do and secure our future. Thank you, Congressman.
Thank you, Mr. Bell. All right, for Mr. John Starks, the next person on the list is David Carter. He holds a few times a few years and he turned out to be able to make it. Is David Carter here? All right, I don't think so. Forward. So the next person on the list is my friend, we have up for recession. Mr. John
Starks. Thank you, Chair. My name is David Lyons. I live at 3450 Drive in Snow Camp. Where I'm home. I would like to ask each and every one of you commissioners that you've got an awesome task here before me. The support that Frank talked about, Agriculture is alive and well in Alamance County. We had it on the Women's Department of Aid. I speak to you tonight with concerns. I look at this budget. We're looking to add more positions, new positions, admin. We're looking at $5 million more in debt. We're looking at using another $5 million out of our fund balance. Commissioners, many of you remember this, that we went down this road 7 years ago. I don't want to say us to pay ourselves in history and getting out of proceedings that the state government can come in and that's up. We have operating, I'm sure we have operating as much efficient as we can. We only have certain limited amounts of ways of raising revenues. Right now, you know, it's through property tax. I know that we love it in strongly, the bonds, but I know too that those bonds are up to you. Whether or not you decide to implement the process, it's up to you. The 7 cents has been proposed to do those bonds. And I'm not saying that those improvements and stuff are not needed. But quite frankly, I don't think the 7 cents is going to cover. We're just looking for keeping the hand out of the vote. We're looking at $500 million. Capital improvements. That's debt budgets, what Mr. Kager has said, that $1.544 million. The 9.6 cents was to take care of that. The 9.6 cents was not to take care of $1.4 million. $1.44 million, so I'm short there, so we will be looking for the more money back from our fund balance to equal that. And then we'll look at it, creating another debt. We already had $45 million in debt. We'll carry the debt over $8,993,000. We have a school debt of $45,763,000. We'll pay for more premium. We just continue, it seems, to spend money and create more debt. Just because we can get it, you know, we have to spend it. My other thing that I would like to get to before my time runs out is, call Mr. Haywood for looking ahead on the improvements of building new buildings, support our camera. Parking is very expensive, and I don't think there's one way that we need to go. I think it's time to do look at going outside this
starting up a government complex.
We talked about this, I mean, the commission talked about this several years ago. In fact, we bought property at Vernon with an education, and then we turned around and sold that property. We're boxing ourselves down in that area, Brandon. We're at a fast growing rate right now. We're projecting Ashford, 44,000 people. We need to look at an outside facility, complex, if you will. And to meet our needs in now and in the future, I think that the facts that we got, that we mentioned in that last meeting, will certainly help the problems that we have now, but the time those things are done, they can be obsolete. We can be right behind them all again. So why not go around somewhere where we can expand and build what we need? It'll be much cheaper. It's easier to build new than to hire anyone. So I would ask that y'all please just look at that and consider that before we make the decision on that. I know this is just an ongoing thing, but it's something that we need to look at. Even a parking lot would be better than these parking decks. Thank you for the time.
Would not have been as high as proposed. But that said, it's time to move forward. The Alamance Chamber has a long history of supporting local education through several of our local winter programs, such as the classroom election, teacher of the year, teacher tour for teachers, and ALA, that directly supported by teachers and students. In addition, the Chamber proudly serves as a community partner for the ABSS vision process and the subsequent strategic plan process, which were the foundational steps that preceded the development of these bonds, at least for ABSS is concerned. The bond packages, their potential costs, and possible revenues necessary to fund them were developed through a very diligent and public process, and fully informed, the public ultimately voted overwhelmingly in favor of the bonds. The Alamance Chamber recognizes and appreciates the hard work and the time and the effort that the staff and you as the commissioners have delivered in developing this important budget, which begins to deliver what the vote is voting for. That's the written piece. I'll share with you a quick story that emphasizes all of this. In my role as an economic development person, I have the privilege of being in the car with companies representatives who are looking at communities to figure where they're going to go, where they're going to put their facilities. One day I was in a car with a gentleman and we were riding around in the town I was working in at the time, and he says to me, "Can you tell me what the history is of your community passing bond issues?" And I said, "Well, I can't give you the exact information that you want, but I can get it." I said, "I haven't had that question put to you before. You haven't asked it in any other way. Tell me why it's important to you. I'd love to know what you're thinking is on that." And he said, "Well, you know, it's just a personal thing. It's a personal metric for me." He said, "My company's getting ready to put $30 million somewhere. We're going to invest $30 million in some community somewhere." He said, "Why would I want to recommend my company spend $30 million in a community that I'm going to invest in itself?" And so that has always stuck with me as a good justification for why communities need to invest in their future. And so I commend this community for voting for the bonds. I understand the work and the challenge it is to go and balance that and everything else you have to do. But we appreciate the leadership you all show. The Chamber supports you in passing the proposed budget. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay. Johnson, if you could please come to
the mic, that would be. And I appreciate the chance to speak tonight. I will be brief. I represent City of Graham, I'm Graham City Council. I live in Graham, 2116 Waterside Circle, City of Graham. But I'm here today as a citizen of Graham. I think a reflection of values and definitely the father of an incoming kindergarten this fall. I want to briefly just say I would appreciate any consideration on behalf of my community. I think we need this and we want this. And we work hard and learn today strategically to get there. I think we're at a place where we can improve the budget that makes sense. Represented the full of the City of Graham. I'm part of it, but I'm part of my peers, and a good part of Graham that really wants to respond and full consideration and its approval. Thank you.
Before Ms. Johnson starts,
Dustin,
is the end of the people who signed up in advance of the meeting to speak. Everyone who is here prepares to speak, we will definitely make time for that. So at this time, anybody who feels moved to speak, please come to microphone 8 and wait your turn. And then when the Johnson is finished, you just come on up to microphone 3 and we'll just keep running the two microphones like that until everybody has had an opportunity to be heard. I hope that's clear, so let me know. So whoever wants to speak, come on down to 8. And Johnson, are you ready to start?
Good evening, Rebecca Johnson, from the 2000 base in the Rock Hill River. I stand here on behalf of the Alamance Journalism Association of Educators, and I stand here for my students. I ask that you all vote in favor of the Alamance County Capital Plan and the manager's recommended budget for the 2019-2020 fiscal year. This plan and budget will move our county in the direction of giving our students the schools that they deserve, as there are about 50 counties with a higher property tax and 50 counties with a lower property tax. With this 8-cent increase, we will remain below the 69.5 median. As many citizens voted for the bond, the non-payment of the sales tax. This is how we're proposing that we will have quality schools here in Alamance County. Education is everybody's business. Every adult is responsible for every student. We are asking that you accept what the county manager is proposing in the last. These buildings with walls, with four walls, full tomorrow inside. It's an investment, a word investment. Our students are worth it. Every citizen wins in the end. Many of our ADSS students are going to continue to further their education at ACC. We currently have early college students already attending. Many adults attend as well to attain degrees for better employment opportunities. Well, we're disappointed that many of our academic coaches that play a high role will not continue in their roles. We hope that they can be put back this year. $159.67 is an important investment. Our students will go on to be doctors, nurses, lawyers, dentists, store owners, and educators as well. As I approached the door, there was a student that attended the daycare with my son, who was so excited and recognizing me as I walked up the steps and told me that his brother was accepted into UNC and was going to go on to be an oral surgeon. So we too will come back and invest in Alamance County. They will become productive citizens of Alamance County that will take care of you and I. We are extremely pleased with the planning that has gone into this, and it's important that the work continues. Let's give our students the schools they deserve by accepting them less than the state's single tax increase. This will move us into the direction to have strong students, strong schools, and a strong community.
My name is Lori Seiler. I'm on the 3743 Conswell Road in Burlington. My husband and I moved to Alamance County 26 years ago, and we started a business and bought property, a home with 5.5 acres. We have no children. We've become very involved in this community. We consider this our home. And we love this community. We love everything. We love the people of this community. And I'm here today to speak on behalf of the budget as proposed. Even though we don't have children, we want the children of Alamance County to receive a world-class education. We are both very active in Alamance County, volunteering and serving various boards. And we are here to rally, or I am here to rally, together with those of our community about the education. We are supportive of the county manager's proposed budget that puts us on the path. And I thank you so much for your time.
Good evening. I am Freebird McKinney from 3025 Truett Drive here in Burlington, North Carolina. And thank you for allowing me to speak tonight. I wanted to talk briefly about the importance of building bridges. And as we work in our classes with civic engagement and learning to give back and service, we work with a poem called The Bridge Builder. It's by Will Out of the Jungle. And I won't read the whole thing. But there's this old man and he's traveling. And he arrives at a chasm and he has to walk through this chasm and he has to cross it on his own. It's windy, it's stormy. And then a fellow pilgrim walks up to him. So I want to read the last two stanzas and just briefly talk. It says, "Old man," said a fellow pilgrim near, "you're wasting your strength with building here. Your journey will end with the ending day. You never again will pass this way. You've crossed this chasm deep. And why build this bridge at evening time?" And the builder lifted his old gray head. "Good friend, in the path I have come," he said, "there followed after me today a youth whose feet must pass this way. This chasm that has been as not to me, to that fair-haired youth may a pitfall be. He too must cross in the twilight dim. And good friend, I am building this bridge for him." And I just wanted to say, in the spirit of this message, to thank you for your leadership and your courage with the support of the school bonds and your willingness to invest, to move our community forward with this proposed budget. And we ask that in doing this, you continue to support the 8% for the necessary capital outlay plans, which will allow our county to function at its highest level and really facilitate our future. So thank you for your vision, Thank you for your future service to our county, and we collectively and collaboratively say thank you.
My name is Charles Sutter. I am from 6707 West 9 Road. It's Snow Camp. I run a cattle operation there. And I was asked to come and speak in favor of the current budget that you proposed. And in my 40 years here in Alamance County, I think the level of growth that we're beginning to see is exponential. I think we're being squeezed from the east to the west, and that we're going to grow at a very rapid rate. And I would ask the county commissioners to please support this increase in the tax rate. I realize that I don't want to pay this, but I am fully in favor of paying for better education, both for my children who have already benefited from the education here in Alamance County, and for my grandchildren who I hope will do so. I just, earlier today, had the pleasure of spending time with Dr. Gatewood down in Sacramento Hall, talking about educational issues in the county, and find that Alamance Community College is doing an excellent job of stepping out, trying to find the needs that this county has, and I would hope that you give your full support to this study. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr.
Well, County Commissioners, I am Drew Blaine, pastor of First Baptist Church on Apple Street, 508 Apple Street, Burlington, North Carolina. Immediate past president of the Interdenominational Ministry of Alliance. I stand in support of the recommended budget by the county manager, the 80-cent investment in the future of our youth in our county. Members of our community took a bold step in voting for the bond referendum to help move Alamance forward. Of course, all progress comes with a price, and I strongly encourage our commissioners to support the budget as we work together to move Alamance forward. Thank you.
Fires, we're doing fire prevention. So I congratulate you all on what you've done,
And I just want to say that I fully support the budget as it is proposed. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, my name is Jeff Andrews, and I live at 818 Warwick Court in Burlington. I am chair of the Alamance Citizens for Education Board, but I would also make a disclaimer that I'm speaking here as a citizen of the Alamance County voter. I haven't really intended to speak tonight. I wanted to listen to the comments, but given the opportunity, I would like to add my voice to those voices that are supporting the approval of the budget as presented, especially as it applies to education. I've heard a number of comments in support of that budget, and specifically in support of the educational proposals for Alamance Community College and for ABSS. I would just like to say that I truly believe in the value of education. And I truly believe what people are saying tonight and have said for as long as I can remember discussions on education. And that is to think of this as an investment. The monies that you put into education are going to be returned to this county. Educated individuals are going to raise children who again, if they ever see the value of education, and if they see this community supporting education, those children are going to come back to this community. When we can see the value of education in our social services, we could lower the cost and scope of our social services if we would have a more educated population. We can do the same with mental health. We can do the same with so many aspects of our budget. So don't look entirely at this as a cost item. It is, as has been said many times, and this is not anything that is generated from me, but it is truly, truly an investment. And I hope you will see that. I know you're going to have some tough, tough decisions. But I think that this education portion of our budget is the central core, and it must be protected. I thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Requests presented by the Sanctuary and the Higher Council.
Yeah, what's that? Yeah, all right.
I've said this many times. When I looked at $150 million for 39 million miles back last year, it was a scary number. But then looking at where the needs were and what the consequences of not building what we need to do would look like, it became easier to get behind the process. I mean, the one thing that really surprised me the most, and maybe not a surprise, but probably the most, was the fact that the sales tax rate. I know people have a tendency not to vote for anything that has the word tax in it. If anybody knows me, I haven't voted for taxes all my life, so I stand kind of scandal on my face, I think, right now, just even supporting the tax, but that sales tax would help us reduce the property tax rate. I'm not saying we can look at that again next year, but I don't think anybody will want to look at it if we don't have a public, public concern to say, let's look at the property tax on taxes and sales tax. Sales tax brings in $1.9 million. We've got a couple options, not just there, but another option would be a local option tax on taxes to bring in over $9 million. So those would have a serious impact on the property tax rate. That means that if there's a voter that if you think about it, I hope they'll consider that for the coming year. The fact is, we've got to get a lot of work done. We've got, as fast as we're growing, we have a lot of things we need to be dealing with. I said on my rant, I may only be here 4 years, and people don't know what happens while I'm here. I mean, I think it's the second time in my life lesson. So, let's do the right thing, folks. Let's get it right. And I appreciate what everybody did, both of these moms. And now we're going to play the pipe.
One thing I can say about the schools, if you don't do something to put discipline in the schools, the place is going to fall apart. I keep getting phone calls of teachers saying that the place is crazy. I'm tired of hearing that. Y'all need to put the school board needs to throw a back button and put discipline in our schools. That's a fact.
Take the opportunity to thank Brian David and the other people in the manager's office, especially Andrew Rollins and Susan Evans and Michelle Mills, and the assistant county managers, Bruce Walker and Jerry Wilson. I'm sorry if I'm missing somebody else for their privilege on this budget. As chair, I have the privilege of working with Mr. David on a lot of different kinds of issues. And I'm personally living this hard work, his staff, he and staff put into this budget since really last August, I think, is when he started working on it in earnest. And I think that all that work and all that preparation really shines through in the presentation that you made to the board, his thoroughness and perspective, really. Also, I want to go back to what Henry Ron said about where we should, if we expand the town buildings, where should that be built? Should we build a separate campus outside of the municipality or someplace that's unoccupied, easy to put a complex on? And first, I would say Mr. Ada's suggestion of that, you know, when he did the capital presentation that he did. That was the first time I heard this idea, and I'm sure the other commissioners would say the same. That was a really preliminary step and a long process and a long discussion. But I personally was cautioning against thinking of building a complex remote where everything has to drive to it. You know, if you picture in your head, you see parking lot all around it, you see a road, people all have to drive. You know, we have, I know the city of Grand is participate in the process of some of the change, and also Alamance County is participating in that. So there is some public transportation available to the downtown building. It's convenient to the interstate. And also there's an opportunity for people in the villages to get something to eat, enjoy the great businesses, while they're praying when they come to the courthouse. And all that's an important amount of job. If we went like that, what happened in town, we would do complex outside and with it. And I've been to that, it's been a while. But it was nothing near it. And you do have the wood kind of businesses to come up around it, but chain, fast food restaurants, stuff like that. There's just people in the track. And I think that if we want to help keep Alamance County the authentic, and true to ourselves, who we are, who we look seriously at having county government complexes centered in the county seat of right. That's our county seat. And I think our county should be seated there. That's my personal thing. And I just want to respond to Mr. Johnson, I think we'll love him and appreciate him coming out tonight to make this remark. So that's all I have to say.
I think one other thing just to mention is that this process is very open to the public. They're going to be able to see what's going on with their money as it's being spent at ACCC and at ADSS. So I thank Brian also for what he's done with the county by putting proposals on our website so where people will be able to access the city where their money's going, which I think is very important.
That's a very good point. There is a ton of information available on our website about the capital plan and other ideas that corporate management. So, anything else you can say about that? If not, we can go on to the approval to apply for the grant from the sheriff's office. Okay, there's three. Usually, I would take a recess at an hour and a half into the meeting, or just an hour into it. Y'all don't want to stand feet out the door for the sheriff's not talking. We need to take a recess. But if you feel like you're okay, we don't have much else to do. So. Sheriff, what's your
shake? Am I safe? First of all, thank you, Commissioner, tonight. And I'd also like to be here. Brian Hagan and his staff has done an outstanding job on the proposed budget. Even though he cut me a little bit, I appreciate it because I know what y'all are up against and what he's up against, and I don't mind taking that. And in retrospect of that, I'm asking me tonight to be able to apply for a Paul Coverdale Forensic Science Improvement Grant. $250,000, no match. This is a purpose funding. This is an enhancement of your forensic capabilities. We have a computer forensic lab at our sheriff's office, which we need. Also, CSI, our crime scene investigative unit, will be able to use the equipment in the field. Additional analytical chemistry lab for chemical trace evidence and identification of illegal drugs. That's what this money will be used for. It is no match. It costs the county not a single dime. And it saved me from having to come back and beg for another home.
I'll make a motion.
We have a motion to approve the sheriff's office response to this grant. Is there any more discussion? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much.
We do have a public speaker opportunity at the end of the agenda for items that are not related to the agenda, and we did have an amount that asked to be added to the staff here. And then you have 3 minutes to speak on the issue of public interest.
Thank you, Commissioners. Once again, I'm in your minds. Thank you for allowing me to speak. I'm here tonight on behalf of the Women's Committee of the Alamance County Farm Bureau, and I would like to invite each and every one here tonight to a safety event that they're having. As you're all aware, probably, that next month is Safety Month in the state of North Carolina, and the Women's Committee are going to hold a safety event, and it will be located at the Lamb Chapel across from We have several different people who's coming to this event. Sheriff's Department has been gracious and offered a lot of different things. We don't have the airport, we don't have the dogs there, we don't, I don't know what all we are, we don't have there. My wife's doing most of this stuff. But we also have a rescue unit that's going to be there, or the city police will be there. The fire department, Vernon Fire Department, will carry on highway control, ag safety, all these things. We're going to have blood testing for sugar and blood pressure. And from the extension office, we'll have a program on fire ants. Fire ants is beginning to be a big problem. And a lot of people don't understand that these are health risks, especially to young children. They can, can actually die from these things. And also the food safety. We'll have a program on food safety there. So again, that's June the 8th, and it will be from 10 o'clock to 2 o'clock. And the first 500 people that come, we'll get a hot dog or something to drink. And I'll be cooking, so don't hold me against me.
You know the food safety first?
Yeah, we're going to do that first. But anybody that would like a flyer, I have some. Just see me after me, and I'll be looking at it. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, Mr. Manager, do you have a
question? I do. First of all, I'd just like to quickly thank the ADSS staff and staff here at the hospital for working so well with our IT department. They're doing so tonight. We really appreciate it. Thank you for hosting and for working so well with our folks. And I want to thank the board's attention, the public's attention. We have set up a new website located at alamancecapitalprojects.com. You'll be able to go through this website and see all this will be where we'll be posting information about county capital projects, court system capital, school system, and the community college. So it's very thorough. It'll be updated as we meet regularly with ADSS and ACC staff. Again, the website is alamancecapitalprojects.com. You can press release about that this evening. But I would encourage everyone to go there. It will be where you can see all the data about bond and non-bond projects for education in Alamance County, as well as county government responsibilities. Thank you to Michelle Mills for the outstanding job putting the website together. It's very thorough and very transparent. So I encourage the commissioners to take a look at it, and everyone in attendance, please, you shouldn't visit us. That's all that I have.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Alamance County Board of Commissioners occur on the first and third Monday of every month in the Commissioners' Chambers at the County Office Building at 124 West Elm Street in Grand. Typically, the first meeting of the month occurs at 9 a.m. and the second meeting occurs at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the county website at www.alamance-nc.com. The video of this meeting is broadcast on LocalGov TV. Please go to www.localgovtvnc.com for more information about this schedule and to see more videos produced by your local governments. You can also access this meeting through our website at www.alamance-nc.com or at our YouTube channel. Technical questions regarding this meeting's broadcast or production may be sent to our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. This address is for technical questions only. Comments and questions about the content of the meeting may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. There, you can click on the link that says County Commissioners to learn more about our commissioners, read minutes and agendas of commissioner meetings, and find other information about the county commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on all our latest video content. If you're watching on LocalGov TV, be sure to visit their website to see all of the content made for you by your local governments.